BuzzFeed recently laid off, I believe the number is more, it's over 220 employees. And there's actually another unfortunate story, which we'll just lightly touch on. The Australia founding editor was one of the people who got cut, apparently. So this is all relatively breaking news. But the issue today is how I want to talk about, listen, you all know me, center-left, social liberal, not far left. I think unions are a good thing to a certain extent. I have been a member of two unions who did basically nothing for me but took money and I had no choice. And I was rather upset about that. I also found that when I was in the Transportation Workers Union, I was held back by union rules. I couldn't ask for raises. I couldn't ask for promotions. I was restricted because collective bargaining. I think collective bargaining can be a good thing. But you have to realize only when your company is making money do you have leverage. When you unionize, you are essentially saying, listen, you got a good thing going on right now, and it's time you up the benefits to the people who help make that system possible. If you refuse to do it, we will band together and bargain as a group, and that can end what your good thing is. Many companies, if they have the room, you have the leverage, they say, okay, listen, we do have great profits, we have a lot of money, what do you want? We want to make sure the machine keeps churning, we want to make sure the system keeps rolling, so we'll give. But what happens when your employer has no money? Though they generate revenue, they're in the red. Well, when you try to collectively bargain against someone who's actually losing, they're going to say, I got nothing to give, dude. You can ask for whatever you want. I ain't got it. So what happens then? We have seen this time and time again. These writers in these newsrooms in New York, they don't understand how economics works. They don't understand that their companies make no money. They think revenue is profit. It's not. Okay, so BuzzFeed lays off a ton of people, and here we go. What is it? A couple weeks later? Not all fun and memes. BuzzFeed News employees plan to form a union. Okay, I'm not saying it's entirely wrong to form a union, by no means. What I am saying is, listen, you don't have leverage right now. Your company isn't doing that well. You sell cookware, okay? Your company's, like, you have a cookware revenue stream. You have to realize if your media company is trying to sell two brands of cook, I'm not making this up. I don't know if you don't follow my videos. Yes, BuzzFeed sells Tasty brand cookware at Walmart and Goodfull brand cookware, among other things, I believe, online. They're trying to offset their costs by selling cookware. So what does that mean? They write articles where they're like, I can't believe how great this pan was. You think kids, these young people go to journalism school to end up writing about pans? You're doing a promo, dude. You're making an infomercial. It's not journalism. So why then do they think forming a union would be in their best interest? Well, maybe because they're about to get laid off again and I want to make sure when they do, they get benefits. But here's the thing. Forming a union doesn't necessarily mean they're going to approach BuzzFeed and make demands. I just think it's very likely they do. And when your company isn't making money, when it's in the red, they'll probably just be like, all right, fine, we'll give you what you want. We're going to lay off 10 people to find the money to do it. But let's read the story. Last month, BuzzFeed laid off more than 220 employees, or 15% of its workforce. On Tuesday, employees at the company news division responded with the announcement that they plan to form a union. Congratulations, your company is in dire straits. They're desperately trying to find and save money, and your response is to put more pressure on the company. Yet, at a certain point, they're just gonna facepalm and be like, "We, you know what? Just let's cut more people. We gotta find money. We got to cut more people, right? You're bare bones as it is. Maybe BuzzFeed's doing things wrong. Maybe they need a union. That's fine. But look, your ship is sinking and your demand, like everyone is trying to bail water. The ship is sinking and you're demanding more from the captain. They say, it's not all fun and memes, the organizing committee said in a statement. Our staff has been organizing for several months and we have legitimate grievances about unfair pay disparities, mismanaged pivots and layoffs, weak benefits, skyrocketing health insurance costs, diversity and more. There it is. So what do you think is going to happen when a company that already laid off 220 people hear that you're approaching them saying, we need to fix these pay disparities. We're upset about the layoffs that come about because you have no money. Our benefits are weak. We want more benefits. You're demanding more from a company that just terminated 220 people? Are you insane? More than 40 of those who lost their jobs in the recent layoff worked in the company's bureau in New York, Washington, San Francisco, and Los Angeles. The cuts included all seven members of the BuzzFeed News National Desk and its seven-person national security team. BuzzFeed's revenue grew by more than 15% in 2018, but that gain wasn't enough to stave off the decision by its founder, Jonah Peretti, to reduce the number of employees. In an email to the staff before the firings, Mr. Peretti wrote, Unfortunately, revenue growth by itself isn't enough to be successful in the long run. No, you need profits. What these people don't seem to understand, even if your total costs are $300 million, BuzzFeed then needs to make more than that to offset those costs. So look, let's say you're not in the red or black, you break even. Investors will be upset, and people and any, you know, people in the company are going to say, we need to make profit, right? A company needs to generate a profit. We need to make money on top of what we're doing, not just cover the bare minimum, for several reasons. It's not just about greed, okay? These people aren't, there's not people twirling their mustache going, we want to make billions of dollars. No. You have to make enough for a rainy day fund, which means a certain amount of money you make above your breaking point needs to go into savings so that you can weather a storm. If you're losing money, you're about to cease to exist, because when you're in the red and your revenue is net negative every year, that means at some point there will be no money. Everyone loses their jobs. The ship is sinking because of too much weight. So they said, you know what? There's not enough people to, you know, expand the ship to make sure it can stay floating. So they got to go. Otherwise, everybody loses out. Well, they trim out 220 employees to try and find that safe buffer where they can probably make money. And what do? We want more. Pay disparities, weak benefits, we want more. Murmurs of a union started among company employees in 2015 when a group of staff members met with the News Guild of New York to discuss the issue of pay disparity, particularly in regards to women and employees of color. The group continued the effort last fall when more than 50 employees participated in a meeting at the News Guild office. So anyway, I should have said this in the beginning. Oh, I'm straight up predicting more layoffs if they go through with this. What is the response to pay disparity? Are they going to go to the white men and say, we are cutting your salaries? Or they'll lay those dudes off. How do you solve pay disparity? Well, there's a couple ways. You can give raises to the women and people of color. That's under the assumption that they're doing the same job. And maybe they aren't. We don't know. But I would be willing to bet the employees at BuzzFeed don't understand the nuance in merit and why some people get paid more than others. They don't. They think everyone should be paid the same. Okay. Well, if we can't give everyone a raise because we just laid off 220 people, what do? Pay cuts to a certain group of people, namely white men, or just fire the white dudes, lay them off. Then you can say, oh, pay disparity solved. We don't got to give anybody raises. We just got rid of the people you were upset about. If they don't have the money, they can't give you a raise, dude. The job losses have further motivated the organizers, according to Dominic Holden. This is the downward spiral. A politics reporter at BuzzFeed News and member of the organizing committee, Davy Alba, senior technology reporter, said by her own estimation, about 90% of eligible BuzzFeed employees supported the idea. Yes, things get bad. The company doesn't make money. They lay people off. The employees panic, try to form a union to demand more from a company that doesn't have anything to give in the first place. Listen, if you're working for a company that is offsetting its costs, it's laying people off and it's selling cookware at Walmart, for Christ's sakes, you don't have the leverage to demand more. You do not. I warned my friends at some other companies. I'm not going to name the specifics of the companies. They were talking about unionizing, and I said, listen, I just want to give you a heads up. You will lose your job. Listen, I know it's not a guarantee, but if I were to give you my opinion, the moment you unionize, management is going to say, well, that's it. We need to find money. And they're going to start slashing jobs to try and make up for those losses. I'm not saying unions are bad. If the company is doing something wrong, then so be it. The issue is that if you're at a company that isn't making money, that is already laying people off, well, then I guess they're going to have to lay more people off. If you expect BuzzFeed to do right by improving benefits, providing better healthcare, and all the things that these employees should have, if there's no money, there's no money. They'll have to lay off more employees to get that money too. And maybe they should. Maybe that's the right thing to do. Maybe they shouldn't be employing the, you know, 1,000 plus or whatever employees they have if they can't afford to pay them what they're worth or what they deserve. Okay. I'll also add too, if you need a job and BuzzFeed offers you trash and you take it, well, maybe you shouldn't have. And I often hear from, I've had friends working for these companies say things like, you know, but I want to live in Williamsburg. Williamsburg is a hipster neighborhood in New York, for those that don't know. It's very expensive. Well, too bad. When I worked at Vice, I slept on my buddy's couch. Couple $100 a month. I said, you know what? I'm gonna trim costs. I accept that. I accepted the job. I took the risks and I slept on a couch. What was it right? Should Vice have paid me more to make sure I can afford to live in the area? That's on me. I took what they offered. I wanted the job. I didn't have to work there. I could have done anything else. A BuzzFeed spokesman did not immediately comment on the original organizing effort. Ben Smith, the editor-in-chief of BuzzFeed News, said in a statement, "We look forward to meeting with the organizers to discuss a way toward voluntarily recognizing their union." BuzzFeed workers have already had some success in challenging management. Days after the layoff, roughly 600 current and former employees signed an open letter posted on Medium that pushed Mr. Peretti and other executives to compensate the laid-off members for unused vacation and comp days as part of their exit packages. Congratulations. They laid people off to find money. You then demanded they pay more. They did. You are squeezing them dry. You are squeezing a company dry when they're already desperate to find money to avoid more layoffs. Congratulations. You're only... It's a system, okay? Let's imagine you have $100 and you have 10 people each asking for $10. One day someone comes to you and says, "We all demand $11. You look at your wall and you say, "I only got $100. That's $110 I don't have." Okay, I got it. If I fire one of those people, I can distribute dollars amongst the rest. Congratulations. That's how the system works. If the money isn't there, they can't pay it. Now, I'll end by saying this. It's entirely possible BuzzFeed does have the money. It really is. And if that's true, then shame on BuzzFeed. I mean, they're a private business to an extent. They can laugh who they want to find money. But if they do have the money, if they do have the revenue, then they should be making sure they pay fair competitive wages. And a union is the reaction you could expect from that. But I'm going to have to say, I really doubt that's the case. I do. It's possible. And if it is, then great. Good on them for doing the union. But I'm going to go ahead and bet that based on the trends in media in general, laying people off was a desperate attempt to find that buffer where they can be in the black and save money to protect themselves from a storm. And you're trying to attack the rainy day fund, okay? There's only one thing I see happening. More layoffs. You can expect more layoffs. If the money ain't there, they can't pay out. However, what may happen is they'll form a union. Good for them, you know, by all means. I'm not opposed to that. And then, you know, executives and management just say, "Okay, congratulations on your union. We don't have any money. Like, this is it. We're in the red. We're going to have to lay people off soon, so we can't give you anything. End of story." And if the employees want to go on strike, well, then there you go. That's the downward spiral of BuzzFeed. Plain and simple. But anyway, I'm going to end there. I don't want to go on too long. Stick around. I got a video coming up on my main channel, youtube.com/timcast, 4 p.m. I will see you then.